We're going to let you do your closing statement. What are the things that you would like to talk about that maybe we haven't touched on before?
Well, we did touch on roads a little bit. I've been around the county this summer a lot, and that's most all rural people that live in the county, that's the first thing they want to talk about. Now, is that the fault for our road department? I don't know. I think last winter had a lot to do with it. But last March, I had about three people, well, more than that, five people come and ask me to run for commissioner. And one of them sitting in this room right now, and I thought about it. I didn't know. I consulted my family and have leased my farm out to my son and daughter-in-law. I decided maybe it was time to try and serve Toole County in a way that I had never done before. So with that in mind, if I do get elected, I will give it 110%. I will be there when I have to be there, when I'm 5 days a week, and I will go out and consult the people in the county several times to see what their ideas are and what we can do. With that in mind, I know we're running on very limited budgets in certain areas, and so you have to keep that in mind when you go and say that you're going to do this or that, because you're only going to do what the law allows you to do and what federal and state mandates let you do. And so therefore, I think that we need to just try and improve what we can improve, work on what we can work on, and do the best job we can. Thank you.
Chandler, your closing statement?
Thank you. I'm going to stand up because I don't want to get fired up about this. I just want to tell you why I'm running. I've knocked on a lot of doors in the county, and I've said the same thing at every single door. The reason why I'm running is simple. I've been running the bowling alley. Me and my wife have been running the bowling alley now 9 years. Since we ran the place, there's now been 3 restaurants that have closed in Shelby. Did you know that the Mexican restaurant just closed down? There's been 2 bars that have closed down in Shelby. And I guess we're not even talking about the Swiss Cafe here in Sunburst, or the Derrick in Kevin. Now, all of you see it. I know you do. And I see it too. When somebody asked me to run for office, I only had to think about it for about a day. I don't want to be the next restaurant to close. I don't want to be the next bar to close. So when I asked people, why do these places close? Well, you know, a couple people whispered to me and said, oh, it's bad management. You know what? There's lots of poorly managed places that survive. But if you don't have workers to work at the place, that's why the Mexican restaurant closed. They didn't have the workers. I think it's unbelievable that we live in a county that probably has 100 good jobs right now. 30 jobs at the border, 30 jobs at the prison, 30 jobs between the hospital and all the egg places on the edge of town. But where are the workers? Seriously, where are the workers? If all of our young people in the county worked, we wouldn't be in this situation. And honestly, the problem is this. I think that previous administrations have done a great job on job creation, but we've done a terrible job of importing people to town. Now let me tell you a little story. Did you know that the hotel on the hill was offering $12 to $14 an hour for housekeepers this summer? Housekeepers. Now I'll tell you, I had to think, man, housekeeping, that's not too bad, considering I only pay myself a little bit more than that. Now, did you hear why they had to pay $12 to $14 an hour for housekeepers? Because they weren't able to get in their truckload of Mexicans in for the summer. Now, I have to tell you, I don't have anything against Mexicans, but we have to do our best to not bring in Mexicans to Toole County. We need to bring Montanans to Toole County. I give a lot of credit to the prison and the border for bringing in out-of-towners, but you know what? When you bring a person from Alabama or Texas up to work at the private prison or up at the border, as soon as the snow flies, they are gone. I'm originally from Plentywood. My wife is from Hamper. Those are the type of people we need to be pinpointing. Now let's go back to that housekeeper. You know, I know that there's a housekeeper in Kalispell right now. She's raising a family. Las Vegas. We didn't know that we were stumbling upon the American dream. That's exactly what we have to offer. That's how we need to sell our area. Now let me tell you my idea to sell it. I don't know how many of us are on Facebook, but if you want to advertise on Facebook, you can micro-target. I can target that woman who works at a gas station or works at a hotel. We can target that person who lives in an apartment, is even living paycheck to paycheck. Because you know what? You can't target the entire Kalispell Valley, but you can target those specific workers. That way we're not bringing in the riffraff, we're not bringing in welfare people, we're bringing people who actually want to work. Now, I heard people like living in Kalispell because they want to be close to Glacier National Park. Well, you know what? If the traffic is bad, we're just as close. And our houses are a quarter of the price. A quarter of the price. The fact of the matter is this. We need to reach out to Montanans. We need to reach out to former Toole County residents and get them to move back. They know how great of a county we live in, and that's why I'm running. I don't want to be the next place to close down. Now let me finish with this. The person who asked me to run for office is a Republican. In fact, most of my friends at the bowling alley are Republicans. So I asked her, I go, are you kidding me? You know I'm going to run as a Democrat. Are you just leading me out to be the sacrificial lamb? And she goes, no, people know who you are, JD. They know how much effort you put into the community. And frankly, this is the bottom line, and this is what I want you to go home with. Montanans, we vote for the person, not for the party. That's why I'm hoping that you'll consider me in November.